Yoga Bom Bom Ti Chini Tanchu Mungong Du Sus.
All right, thank you so much. I think I went through everybody. So next, I'm missing one person, which is Tanjanique. Tanjanique Miller, you have the floor. She's our finance director.
Good evening. I don't have a report prepared.
All right, thank you.
Who is in the office with her? Who did you just look at? I really wish I was in her mind. Is anybody out there with telepathy that can read her mind in this old ass video? What was that? Was you scared that Tanjanique was gonna have a report? Do she know she not supposed to even chime up? It seemed like maybe you only said her name because you had to. Like, I just got all the questions. But most of all, who did you just glance at? Who is in the office with you? Is it Keith Freeman? And why did you look at him like that? Keith, how much of this story is you going to tell? Is you going to do the movie? Is y'all going to make a movie about Tiffany? It's going to be on Netflix.
Nick Miller. You have the floor. She's our finance director.
Watch the glance. It might just be me. I'm crazy. I'll be
good evening. I don't have a report prepared.
All right. Thank you.
Right there.
Okay. So next, I'm just going to give you guys a couple updates of what's going on from the mayor's office. And then we will conclude this evening's board meeting. I appreciate everyone that has attended and everyone that took the time out of their day to come on to hear what we had to say. When I say wow, I mean wow. It's been so much going on in this last week.
When I say wow, I mean wow. This is those amazing acting skills that she picked up while she was practicing to audition for the Shark Tank. The fuck? I just wanted to stop it just to say, we're going to keep it in our third mind's eye behind, in the part of our brain right behind our left ear. We're just going to keep it back there because I'm going to forget. But y'all remember, this is the board meeting right before the actual next board meeting that I saw. I don't know how many more she canceled, but the next board meeting where they had a meeting, it's back in person. So we're going to see if Tanjanique Miller is going to show up. And her access is going to be unfettered at that point where they can ask her questions and stuff like that since she don't have no report. I don't think she allowed at the meetings, or if she is, not allowed to many of them.
It's been amazing. First and foremost, I would like to thank everyone for all your calls, text messages, flowers, and cards to congratulate me on my new appointment at the Thornton Township as your new supervisor. I would say this, I have big, huge shoes to fill from the late Frank Zuccarelli, who was my mentor, my friend, and I will not let you down. You have taught me a lot, and now I'm happy to know that I will lead your legacy.
That don't even sound right. That don't even sound like you really respect it. Frank Zuccarelli. I've never heard anybody say, well, not that I've never heard it, but the phrase just sounded weird to me. And she did it with a pause, like she knew her mouth was supposed to automatically say the word. She said the late Frank Zuccarelli and then gave him kudos and praises and mentor and this and that. Not the late great Zuccarelli. And to lead, did she say lead his footsteps or lead his legacy? What you mean lead the legacy? You're supposed to be fulfilling. You're supposed to try to fill the shoes. You're supposed to, I don't know how else you're supposed to phrase it, but you're supposed to try to be the person or as good of a person. You know, you're supposed to put it in that, not say, I'm going to show you what your legacy should be like. And that's what I really think she felt. I do not think she respected that man. That man was not leading a supervisorship the way she wanted to lead a supervisorship. He was doing things maybe too clean. Maybe they was on top of the ocean and they was just floating and it was calm water. She wanted them rocky ass fucking seas with holes in the boat where everybody else is running around with buckets and pails trying to get as much water out of the boat. They distract. That's what she wanted, so that way she could do her job the way she wanted to and lead your legacy, Frank Zuccarelli.
I received many questions about my position here as mayor of the great village of Dalton. Let me take a moment to clarify. Yes, I can and will do both. So for all those that's going around saying I cannot do both, I have to resign. I am not resigning. I will not resign. I will continue to be your mayor who you elected to get Dalton in order. So let's be clear. Anybody telling you that, you're hearing it from the horse's mouth. I can legally hold both positions, supervisor of the township and mayor of Dalton. I am dedicated to the cause, and I guarantee I'm gonna make y'all proud. I think over the last 8 months or so, I've done an amazing job with a great team. Let me make sure I stop for a minute and get my team's back legs. I couldn't have done it without them. My team are my backbones. They have got me to the place I am today. They have came in swinging. When I say we swinging, we fighting every day from the naysayers to just negativity. And I don't know who lives or want negativity in their life like that. But when I say the hate is real, oh God, the hate is real. And it hasn't stopped me. And it won't stop me. It hasn't crushed me. It hasn't demotivated me. Nothing.
They just came in swinging. I promise you, most people don't have to go through what you go through. And I mean people like you. Single black mothers be doing shit on a regular basis and don't be having to have a team of security guards swinging at the haters. When you walk in through and you are a magnet, there's something going on. Why is there no self-awareness, no reflection ever? Why do you not have to improve anything? These great specimens that the world has created, that's just sprinkled throughout, are amazing to me. These people who literally have no faults and make it to like stardom, to be famous in some kind of way. Famous is not really a hard thing to get as we see these days, and just a little crowd has to know who you are, and there's enough people right now who know who you are that if the majority is saying something's wrong, I'm not saying you got to listen to all of it, but some of it, you got to tone it down. You got to tone it down and you got to be self-aware. Years and years and years ago, I realized that common sense wasn't something that a lot of people were born with. Now I'm starting to realize that self-awareness is a disease as well. And it could help a lot of people. It's just small things that if you changed, honestly, being as bad as she is, she could make a huge turnaround and still continue because she has so much favor in whatever little group that she has. I don't know if the rest of them not self-aware, whatever it is. She could actually still keep her position. I promise you she could win somehow, some kind of way. But because she's not willing to change anything, girl, we is here for the mess and we just waiting to see. If the FBI gonna be haters.
I am still standing strong, yes. And I am still thriving, and yes. I am still continuing to make sure I do the best job I can for the residents of Dalton. Because you guys said you wanted change, and this is what change looks like. I want to give a great accolade to one of my trustees, Trustee Holmes. A lot of people thought that once we came out of the election, that we will be into it. When I say we are like the best of friends now, we are the best of friends because we put those things behind us. The race was the race. Now it's time to put in the work. So that's one thing I want to say about that trustee, is that he has been a man of his word. He said he would put his difference to the side and he will come and work for other people. And that's what he has been doing. So I thank you, Trustee Holmes, for just allow me to lead and allow me to show residents what this young, vibrant mayor could do if y'all just let me lead. So I thank you.
You are. dusty trusty. He's seen the signs. He's seen the signs, possibly. Possibly. You know, I don't know if he's ever done anything like what he's accused of now, but he didn't like her when she was running for mayor. Okay. Afterwards, though, she was like, hey, dusty trusty, you can be as dusty as you want to be during my term. And that motherfucker was like, got it. Got it. I'm positive him realizing that he was going to be able to do his dirt while you did your dirt, that he came around. He was the only one who had dirt on the mind. Who had dirt on the mind. Lord Jesus, and it looked like it. Oh my Jesus, I apologize. He was the only one out there looking to do some dirt. And that's why it seems as if he went up under that wing you was holding out there. Girl, this is not no kind of like praises to yourself. Because right now what I'm hearing you say is anything that this man is accused of, just know I led him down this path. Because what? I'm a young, vibrant mayor. And this is a way this shit should be run. I heard you.
Next. Honestly, I'm going to say this. I am humbled and honored that our Thornton Township Board of Trustees believed so much in me that they took a chance on this rookie mayor. Yeah, I said rookie because I was new to the game. No one ever thought or saw that coming, nor did I. So I am thankful to the Thornton Township Trustees for believing in me to take on such a huge task. So I thank you. I am grateful that our Dalton Board of Trustees and I can come together, and hopefully they can put their differences to the side and work together for our residents. But
see how they the only ones with problems? She don't have to compromise. Why do people still say, I just wish y'all could work together today? Like today at a board meeting, if they throw a board meeting, there would be citizens that... How you work together, if they put their differences aside, everybody forget anything that you got going on, anything you mad about, anything you want changed, don't worry about it, don't say nothing, just come out here and do the work for the people.
If we can, I will say this. Remember, ships don't sink because of water surrounding them. Ships sink because the water gets in them. I cannot let what's happening around me get inside me and weigh me down. I will always stay focused on helping the people no matter what. My residents, village, and Dalton will always come first. I've always been the people's trustee, and I'm now the people's mayor. And now I am the township supervisor. So excited, guys. I love it. So I just want to thank all that took a chance on me and believe in me to actually show you guys what we can be if we all just stand together. And I think once you guys see what I do with the township, you will see all along that it wasn't your mayor that had the division going on at the board. It was people playing for power, people playing because they want to be mayor, and all people have to do. Remember, this is democracy. Y'all supposed to run for the office, not come and take something from an individual that earned it, such as myself. The people elected me, not the Board of Trustees. So I don't honor or respect anybody that goes and try to take something or make up laws to remove an individual who have not done anything wrong because of a dislike of an individual. If that's the case, every board, whether it's library, park, or school, will be in trouble because a board member do not like them. That is not how government is ran or set up. And for that matter, that should not be what anyone can or will do because you're mad and upset. That means you're not built for this position. That means you need to resign and let someone that can keep their feelings in check and move the community forward. So let's go on. With that being said, let's get down to business. Everyone know that I have a $1.5 million grant that we are about to dish out to all the seniors and veterans. Make sure y'all got it. Seniors and veterans. And yes, you have to be 65 years or older for either one, whether you're a senior or a veteran, to apply. It is to do your windows, And also to do roofs. And it's a first come, first serve basis. And all you have to do is fill out an application. What we're going to do, I am waiting to open Village Hall. Once we're done with the remodeling, Village Hall will be open. So I get that question a lot, but we are opening. They're still painting upstairs. Once they're done, we will be open. More than likely, I'm praying that it will be April. I don't think it will be by the time of the next board meeting, but if it is, I will announce it. Because I want to see y'all too. I miss y'all like y'all miss me. I want y'all to come through. And if you're looking for the application, you can go to www.vodome.org, and the applications will be posted at the next board meeting of March 21st. I know we did talk to the attorneys, was making sure we crossed our T's and dot our I's, because today I was supposed to release it and announce it, but there's some things that I needed to change on there, and we did change it. So now the final version will be March 21st, so that everyone won't have a lot of questions, because it'll be clear as day as the requirements are read into record. Next is Women's History Month, guys. A lot of people don't understand how thrilled I am for that, because now I am a history maker, and now I will go down in the Wall of Fame for just making history here in the Village of Dalton as the first female mayor, and now being the first female Black supervisor of the township, which the late Frank Zuccarelli held for 30 years. So I want to say my hats off to all the women that's out here thriving and pushing, and keep going no matter what nobody tell you. Because remember, you can be whatever you want to be if you put your mind to it. I always say, take them dreams off the shelf and try to bring them into fruition. Never let no one tell you what you cannot do, because you can do whatever you want to do. Trust and believe me, I am a walking testament of that. So all the naysayers, you let them hate. Your haters are your biggest fans. I've said that several times. Let them promote. Let them put your name in rooms that it would never been in, all because of the hate. But believe it or not, they are actually bastards. We will be celebrating different women that has made an impact in society. So if you know any woman that's great, has been doing awesome things, any community, it doesn't matter. We are taking names now. Please submit them to the communications, Nikita?
Mm-hmm.
Communications.org? What is it?
VODalton.org.
What is it?
Communications@VODalton.org.
Okay, is that communications@VODalton.org? And you can submit someone's name, or you can email us, or you can send it through Facebook, however you like. But make sure you submit whoever that person will be. Next, on Sunday, March 20th at 4 p.m., we will be hosting our first annual Women's Day Award Banquet. Now, that's why I'm telling you, submit your name. If you have your name in this week, they can basically get an award at the banquet on March 20th. Again, it's at 4 p.m., and we will be honoring extraordinary women who are making history all over the world. And this event will be held at the Lester Long Building at the Dalton Park District. That address is 14700 Ever Street. Again, it's at the Lester Long Building in Dalton Park, address 14700 Ever Street. On Tuesday, March 22nd, we'll be hosting Ladies Night. You ever say, it's Ladies Night? Yeah, okay. We're going to be hosting Ladies Night at Dalton Bowl. So come and celebrate with us. It's free. You know me, I always do everything free to the residents. And it will start at 5 p.m. And it is 1401 Sibley is the address. And again, March 22nd, Ladies Night at Dalton Bowl. Address is 1401 Sibley Boulevard. Next date, March 24th, we are having a couple sip and paint. This will also be held at Dalton Park, address 14700 Ever Street.
I don't know. It seems like she's either praising herself, doing shit to entertain herself, or herself and others. At this time, she was with the one guy who was like, fuck that mayor shit. We don't need that. So it seems as if she became the first mayor. So now we're going to have some women's history, women's month thing. Granted, I could be wrong. They may have this on a regular basis, but in my mind, I'm just living out this fantasy. Okay. And now they're about to have a couples. Oh my goodness. I love you, boo. You love me. Let's be together. And let's make the community pay for it. But y'all invited too, so don't complain too much. That man was like, fuck the mayor. And where he at now? I think the mayor said, fuck you. I do wonder, how did we get to the new boo after the first boo, after such a fool? I mean, that man was happy as fuck about that money. And I'm almost positive. I don't be looking at people in their face most of the time. So I'm about 98-99% sure it's not the same person. They different complexions, but I mean, I don't know nothing about nothing, but I think they different people, right?
So ladies, come bring a date and have fun with us. We got raffles and prizes. This is going to be a nice, engaging event. Last but not least, on March 31st, we are hosting our senior St. Patrick's Day luncheon. This event will also be held at Dog Park District, 14700 Evers. Again, the address is 14700 Evers. It is March 31st, the senior St. Patrick's Day luncheon. Now, sometimes, Now that I am your supervisor, some of these events will be held throughout the township, and we will announce different locations in the upcoming week. So some of these might change from that location to a different location. So just please check our website or contact Nikita at 708-297-6859. Again, the number is 708-297-6859. Please visit our website to register. We do appreciate when you guys register because it gives us a head count, so we know how much food to purchase for the event. Our resident services hotline is getting revamped. When I say I love the 1-800 number, I have not gotten one negative call about that. You guys appreciate that you can call and reach a live person at 4 o'clock in the morning. Our new number is 877-845-7609. Again, the number is 877-845-7609. And you can basically call this number to either A, register for events, B, you can call for any down power line, a housing issue, which you shouldn't have infrastructure. So, okay, that was very, very powerful. A lot of residents enjoyed it. A lot of people asked, did we record it? I believe we have some clips of it. We will post it on our social media feed. So look forward to that. And they can even provide resources for grants for down payments for the purchase of a house. So make sure you take advantage of all these wonderful things. My last announcement is to announce that we are having a police and fire board committee meeting. It will be held on 3/10, that is this Thursday at 10 a.m. via Zoom. Again,
I just need y'all to let me know, is this legal what she's talking about right here? I think they should not have gave her the law books and let her pretend like she could read them laws and understand, because I think that's gotten us into a lot of the trouble that we we're not even going to talk about the lawyer who didn't told her yes to some of the things, some of the questions she didn't ask that he knew he should have said no. We're not even going to talk about him. But the fact that she didn't sit down and was like, no, I read this law and I think it's right. Do y'all just let me know, is this legal? Because it don't sound legal, but I don't know nothing about nothing. I literally am just listening to her. And to me, from listening to it, it don't even sound like it's legal.
And we are having a police and fire board committee meeting on March 10th. This Thursday at 10 p.m. via Zoom, so everybody tune in. A.M. via Zoom. And the reason for this is because I've placed the Police and Fire Board Commission on the committee several times, but the Board of Trustees, excluding Trustee Holmes, have chose not to move forward to put this in place. And me, as your mayor, so I'm speaking for Tiffany now, I would never get rid of police or firemen who are our breadwinners of our community. They are our first responders. So the Board of Trustees are in violation of the Board of Fire and Police Commissions Act, 65 Illinois CS 5/10-2.0. That is how you find out what I'm talking about. You cannot hire, promote anybody without going through the Board of Police Fire Commission. So I am no longer going to allow the Board of Trustees to not allow us to move the village forward by hiring younger police officers, putting people through the academy, or having to take anything from people. Because I was instructed that I would have to demote all the promotions we have done for the police or the fire, and I will have to fire any firemen that we just hired. And I would never take that moment from you guys. So let's be clear, speaking to my police and firemen. I vow not to do that, so I'm initiating.
What if it's for a reason? What if they over budget and checks about to start bouncing? Like literally your paycheck is gonna bounce all because you wanted a promotion instead of having your job and waiting until the citizens might be able to afford it, because we can't afford this mayor, this supervisor, her team, and y'all fucking promotions. What if these people were not qualified? I understand you want young. You want youth. That's what you want. We understand for some odd reason, this fountain of youth that you are on the search for, you've discovered it in the young people. Okay? What if they weren't qualified? What if they needed another year of life experience before they put their lives on the line for the people? Like, I just don't know if she really believes that because she says it shall be done, so be it. Like, no, there are some rules to this life. They made up. All of these rules is made up, but there are some rules. And some of them make sense for a reason. You don't put new raggedy motherfuckers out on the street until everybody say they qualified, and until everybody say we can afford it. I understand police should be well staffed. I completely agree with that. Firehouses, firefighters, they should be fully staffed, right? But it's a certain level that you gotta get to before you are the staff, and I completely agree with that. Because if you come to rescue me, we done all seen them fails. Oh my goodness. And I feel like such a horrible person, but I gotta watch them. The fails where they try to put the people on the stretchers and do things with them, and the people fall off the stretchers, or the stretchers themselves fall. You come rescue me from a certain story building and I fall off that motherfucking ladder, or we about to fight in the afterlife. Wait till I catch you on the other side, because I know I'm about to. She say she don't give a damn. She say she not doing that. Is it legal? I just had a question.
That we move forward with the police and fire board, despite what the board of trustees are doing. We should never, ever hold people hostage because of internal fights. And you guys are becoming collateral damage. So I am standing before you with Trustee Holmes. And we are saying we're moving forward because we have to do what's right, no matter if they do what's wrong. And what's right is allowing you to keep your promotion, allowing you to stay employed for those that just recently got hired, allow us to do the right thing, which is have a police and fire board commission so that we can hire new people, new blood, things that is not going on in our community I would like to change. I want to conclude my report by saying I will always put down first. I'm excited for my new endeavors, and I keep telling y'all need to leave God's children alone, because you cannot take anything that's for a person. If it's for them, God gonna see it through no matter what obstacle gets in the way. All we gonna do is jump over the hurdle. We're gonna move forward no matter what. We're gonna keep pushing. And that's exactly what I've done. I've stayed focused. So all my mentors, all the residents, I love y'all to death for just keeping me grounded, keeping me focused, keeping me in a place that I needed to be because of all the negativity that comes with titles. I never saw so much hatred till I became mayor, and then everyone wanted to attack. When everyone has the opportunity to do exactly what I did, run for the seat. But you wait your turn. When the seat comes up, you run for it. You don't sit here and attack me and try to remove me because of your dislike. It's people that I might not like, but I know better. You have to work with everyone. Once the race is over, it is over. It is time to work. And that's what I have done. And I will continue to do that. So I look forward to you guys at my next meeting for supervisor. I think that's going to be epic. I'm looking for any youth that want to get involved or do anything else. I'm over 17 municipalities, so I'm excited just for them giving me the opportunity to show you guys what leadership truly looks like.
Spoiler alert, they was all dirty. They was all doing drugs. probably when she had picked him up at 3:30 at the school to take him to that warehouse in Milton to speak, take him, to teach him Spanish. Because it's a lot of Mexicans, she said, in her area. What the fuck kind of sermon was that? That was a sermon. She write these as if she's a pastor preaching to her congregation. Didn't you just want to say amen? Bye, y'all.